Just a quick reminder that if you could silence any cell phones and pagers, that would be great. And it's really so nice to see you all. I'm really happy to be here. I have a wonderful accompanist, as usual, John Eisenberg. And John, he has done so many things with me already, and we've got a few more things in the future. This also is a partial benefit for this organization called The Battle Within. I'll tell you a little bit more about that later. I'm a Mason, not the brick and mortar, Masonic, and one of our charities we support. This particular one that deals with the tragedy of veteran suicide and PTSD, which apparently is rampant. I did a little research today, and kind of scary what's going on. So that'll be great that we can, you know, hopefully cut them a check and put it towards whatever they need to do their outreach. So thank you. Let me just check my list here.
Hold on.
Hammerstein in this program, as well as some of the other standard folks like Kander and Ed. We're doing a cabaret number later. And Lerner and Noel, who wrote a bunch of stuff. I just personally like melodies, and I think the audience likes familiar stuff, so that's what we're gonna do for most of it. And there are some unusual numbers, which you'll see later, you know, but we're gonna have a good time, so. Okay, take it away, John. Same thing happened with Camelot when she originated Guinevere in the musical. It was later filmed with, I believe, Lynn Redgrave and Richard Harris did the principal roles. So poor Julie, but I think she's done okay. she's proved her merit. So this is what Lancelot sings to Guinevere in his declaration of love. If ever I would leave you.
If ever I would leave you, it wouldn't be in summer. Seeing you in summer, I never would go. Your hair streaked with sunlight, your lips red as flame, your face with a lost star that puts gold to shame. But if I'd ever leave you, it wouldn't be in autumn. Seeing you in autumn, I never would go. I've seen how you sparkle when fall nips the air. I know you in autumn, and I must be there. But could I leave you running merrily through the snow, or on a wintry evening when you catch the fire's glow? Wouldn't be in springtime, knowing how in spring I'm bewitched by your song. Oh no, not in springtime, summer, winter, or fall. No, never would I leave you. Love never made a fool of you. better forget her. Her with her nose in the air, she has you dancing on a string. Break it and she won't care.
But I never saw them win.
Okay, I think I'm ready. This is a really beautiful ballad, and it's a kind of a sad song. It's about a breakup. And anyone who has ever been through a breakup would probably relate to some of the words. And
thank you.
the meadow. The corn is as high as an elephant's eye, and it looks like it's climbing clear up to the sky. Oh, what a beautiful morning! Oh, what a beautiful day! I got a beautiful feeling, everything's going my way. All the cattle are standing like statues. All the cattle are standing like statues. They don't turn their heads when they see me ride by. But a little brown maverick is winking her eye. Oh, what a beautiful morning. Oh, what a beautiful day. I got a beautiful feeling. Everything's going my way. My father is a very hyper, was a very hyper Italian, and he would never ever sit for anything. I mean, he was very good to us kids, but we went to see Oklahoma, the movie, and we also went to see South Pacific when the movie versions were out. My brother and I were in the balcony, and all of a sudden Dad comes in, you know, comes upstairs, and let's go, come on, we got out here. So, we never got to see the whole movie, but I got the gist of it anyway. That's why I'm so messed up. You can't win, right? Who are you? Are you all drunk yet? Well, I can tell you, when I get home, the wine bottle is coming out. This next song, I just happened to chance on when I was perusing YouTube, and it's really become a favorite. It's a beautiful, beautiful ballad by Stephen Sondheim, who sadly passed last year. I think he was 90, I could be wrong, but he has written, you name it. Sondheim is Broadway, so I wanted to do something of his canon of work, because he really is a genius, there's no doubt about that. This is from a show he wrote called Follies, and it's called Losing My Mind. I don't know how that resonates with you, but I kind of have been there. So anyway, I hope you enjoy it. The sun comes up, I think about you. The coffee cup morning as I think about you, I talk to friends and think about you. And do they know it's like I'm losing my mind? All afternoon doing every little chore, the thought of you stays right. Sometimes I stand in the middle of the floor, not going left, not going right. I dim the lights and think about you, spend sleepless nights to think about you. You said you loved me, or were you just being kind? classic. I think I know what happens. I think the guy gets the girl, I don't know. They're on an island somewhere. And the guys dress up like girls and they put coconut boobs on, and I don't know. I vaguely remember some of it, but anyway, Nothing Like a Dame, that was one of the numbers from There's Nothing Like a Dame, nothing in the world. Of course, I would sing, There's Nothing Like a Guy, nothing in the world. Some enchanted evening. I hope you had an enchanted evening.
Stories high.
Thank you. So they're fixed. And I got the lens implants, had the cataract thing done, right? So you're really not supposed to need glasses, right? Because you had the cataract surgery. Screwed again. No boyfriend and reading glasses. Oh yeah, you laugh. You're all going home with partners, right? Bitches. I wanted to read you just some statistics. These are pretty sobering. This is from the Battle Within website, Foundation's website. In the past 40 plus years, since the end of the Vietnam War, we have lost more American heroes due to suicide than all foreign wars and conflicts in the time period combined. Despite the very best efforts of family, friends, and the VA, and scores of highly dedicated veteran-based organizations, approximately 20 veterans, it's actually higher, each day are lost to us due to complications from wounds and injuries we cannot see. And this was from veteranwarrioroutreach.org. Suicides during active service in the military increased by 30% in 2008, with just one soldier, sailor, or marine expected to commit suicide within the next 25 hours. The number of suicides among ex-military personnel also increased by 10% in the same period, averaging around one per hour, according to veteran suicide quotes. 22 suicides a day are unacceptable. More military personnel died from the suicide bug in 2012 than died in combat in Afghanistan. Once they return home to become civilians, they're committing suicide at three times the rate of active military personnel. So pretty sobering. But the good news is that there is help. I was talking to a guy at the gym who, come to find out, was a Marine vet having some serious back problems. And what this poor guy was going through with the Veteran Association to get these appointments, it's like, are you kidding me? You know, I'm not a soldier, obviously. Look, you think I'm soldier material? I'm like radar on NASH. I couldn't even carry a gun. I remember when they had the draft, remember that? And I was so scared, little Tony, I made my father go with me to the federal building because you have to go and register. And I thought, oh, Dad, what am I going to do if they draft me? I don't even know how to shoot a gun. Well, luckily, it was pretty close after that, that thank God that the war ended. But yeah, it's we need our vets, and we need the first responders, obviously, the ambulance people, the doctors, the policemen, the nurses. I mean, they're all so important, but they all suffer from PTSD.
Tony, we just had a young man at the end of our road, and it'll be 2 weeks tomorrow night, 24 years old, had been in service, just re-enlisted for active duty, and whether it was PTSD, whatever, 2 weeks ago he shot himself down there in his house. He was taken to Wilson, but declared brain dead and taken off life support the next day.
Yeah, it's
rocked the whole neighborhood.
It's
there.
Yeah, it's, I mean, I'm lucky to the extent that I don't know anyone personally, but I certainly have talked to people that have experienced it and that have gone through it. And we just, you know, thank you for coming. Thank you all for being here, because once we get all the business taken care of here with the theater, I will make sure that this foundation gets a check to them to continue their fight to assist veterans. And, you know, so thank you again. Now let me finish my song here. To God, he's befriended Marius, the young soldier who's gone off to fight, praying that he will come home. And I'd like to dedicate this to all the vets that don't come home, or those that do come home and just are not in a good state mentally. So again, I thank you all for coming, and I thank John Eisenberg, I thank Ron Harris. Ron in the back, give Ron a hand. And I thank the Playhouse for having me. I did my first show in 2019, and it was a real great experience. And so we've been trying to coordinate for 3 years to come back, and it finally happened. So anyway, this is called Bring Him Home. God on high, hear my prayer. In my need, you have always been there. Bring him home.